Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about light reflection and refraction. Okay, so first one, image formation in concave lens. Last class we learned about image formation in convex lens. Okay, I hope all of you understood all those things, no doubts, right? So that today's task also you did. Okay, on that day I had given you a homework, remembering, right? You did everything, we will discuss together. Okay, so image formation in a concave lens. How we will be finding out the image formation in a concave lens? Okay, it's a concave lens. So here the light ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis, after refraction will diverge and go. That divergent ray will appear to come from the principal focus. That is the first rule for our in concave lens, how we will be getting refraction. If the ray is passing parallel to the principal axis, the ray will be diverging and going. After divergence, if we are extending the divergent ray, it will be meeting at the principal focus. Okay, so that is the first rule. Okay, and the second one is the ray which is passing through the optic center. If the ray which is passing through the optic center will go undeviated. Okay, that is same as the previous one. And third one, if the ray which is coming incidenting on the principal axis, which is passing through the principal focus, okay, which appear to fall on the principal axis, after refraction will pass parallel to the principal axis. Okay, that is the third one. So in these are the three rules. This is the rays which we should use to find out the image. Okay, the rays which are passing parallel will appear to diverge from a point on the, that point is called a principal focus. Okay, then the ray which is passing through the optic center will go undeviated. And the ray which appear to fall on the principal focus after refraction will be going parallel to the principal axis. Okay, clear? So, here next is, if the object is at infinity. If the object is at infinity, how the rays will be coming? See here, first we can mark O, F1 to F1. This is F2 and this is 2F2. The object is at infinity. If the object is at infinity, how the their incident ray will be parallel rays. After refraction, the ray will diverge and go. So if we are extending, it will meet at the principal focus. So one more ray. To find the image, we need two rays, isn't it? So the ray which is coming parallel, because since it is at infinity, so the object incident rays will be coming parallel rays. Okay, it will diverge and go. If we are extending that one, we will meet, we can see the object, the rays will be meeting at F1. So where will be the position of image? Image will be at F1. Image will be at F1, and what will be the nature of image? It's not actually forming, isn't it? We are making it to meet. So it will be a virtual and erect image. If we are making it to meet at one point, means it will be virtual and erect image. What will be the size of the image? It will be a highly diminished image. Because a point sized object image it will be, isn't it? We are getting it as a point. Okay, so highly diminished or point sized image. Okay, so next one is, if the object is between infinity and optic center, if the object is between infinity and optic center, how the image will be? See, if this is the concave lens and this is O, and this is F1, this is 2F1, this is F2, and this is 2F2. Same way we should. Okay, at one point I can mark, because it will be anywhere between infinity and optic center, this is how the graph will be. Okay, so the ray which is passing parallel after refraction will appear to diverge from the principal focus. So the next one, if the ray is passing through the optic center, it will go undeviated. You can see a small image at this position. Okay, so what is the, where the image will be forming? Image is between O and F. Image between O and F. And the nature will be, what will be the nature of the image? It will be virtual and direct, because it's not actually meeting. We are making it to meet, at, isn't it? So it is virtual, virtual image. And what is the size of the image? Diminished image. Okay, it is diminished one, diminished image. Okay, so this is up. So this only these two points. So in the case of concave lens, always we will be getting a virtual and erect image in the case of concave lens. Clear all of you? Okay, so shall we move to the next portion? So next one is sign convention. How we can use the sign convention if it is a convex lens or if it is a concave lens? How it will be? So in the case of mirror, how we did, you are remembering, right? The optical apparatus will be considered as the origin. Same way, here also, here we will consider this as origin. So from here, right side, whatever measurements we are taking, it is positive. Left side, whatever measurements we are taking, it will be negative. And upward direction, if we are considering, it will be positive. And if we are considering the downward direction, it will be negative. So this is same for both convex and concave lenses. So in the case of this concave lens, see, same way, this side it will be positive and this side it will be negative. And here it will be positive, upward direction it will be positive, downward direction it will be negative. Okay, so and all the measurements should start from the optic center. Start from optic center. So all the measurements we should start from the optic center. That is another one. Okay, all the measurements we should start from the optic center. So towards the right side it will be positive and towards the left side it will be negative. Okay, so in the case of a convex lens, so some, how we will be finding out the focus? Parallel rays will pass through the principal focus. Will pass through the principal focus. So this is the focal length, isn't it? So in the case of convex lens, what will be the value of convex, this focal length of a convex lens? Focal length of a convex lens towards the right side, from optic center towards the right side. So it will be positive. Okay, in the case of concave lens, how the measurement? It is diverging and going. It is extending and meeting at the principal focus. Diverging and going, extending and meeting at the principal focus. So from here, it is moving towards the left side. So in the case of concave lens, focal length will be negative. Focal length for a convex lens will always be positive, and focal length for a concave lens, we should always consider it as negative. In the numerical and all, they won't give as it is negative. So if the focal length of a concave lens, if it is given, you should consider it as negative. Okay, clear all of you, the sign convention. So this is, all these things are same like our mirror only. Only thing is, we should start the measurement from optic center and object. And one more thing, the object always at the left side of the left side only we will be keeping the object as per sign convention. As per sign convention, we will always keep the object at the left side of the lens. Okay, clear now? So next we are going to study about the lens formula. Okay, so what is lens formula? So here we are going to study about the lens formula. See, from all the measurements should start from optic center, I told. So from O to optic center, from optic center to object, that distance is called, represented as U. That is object distance is U. Optic center to image, that distance is represented as V. And focal length, what is the representation of focal length, you tell me? Yes, small letter F is the representation of focal length. Then the lens formula is 1 by F equals 1 by V minus 1 by U. This is the lens formula. Okay, 1 by F equals 1 by V minus 1 by U. Okay, 1 by F equals 1 by V minus 1 by U. Okay, so next we are going to study about the magnification. So what is meant, in the name itself it is there. What is meant by magnification? How much enlarged or whether it is diminished? How much it is enlarged or how much it is diminished? That one we can understand with the magnification. Magnification is considered as the ratio of height of image to the height of object. Magnification is ratio of height of image to the height of object. That is magnification. HI by HO. So next is power of a lens. See, what is meant by power of a lens? Power means ability of a lens to converge or diverge. Okay, that depends on. So convergence and divergence of a lens depends on its focal length. Okay, convergence or divergence depends on its focal length. Okay, so the degree of convergence or divergence is called as power. Okay, how much we can converge the rays, how much we can diverge the rays, we know. See, in eye diseases and all, eye defects and all, usually it's a long sight or short sight. Okay, that and all we are going to study in the next chapter in detail. Okay, so but if it is a long sight or it is a short sight, how we will be using the lens, we will be using the lens which we are using will be different. Okay, so how, see, the power will be varying for each and every person, isn't it? Person to person it will be varying. If I have short sight and the other person is also having short sight, the same lens, this glass I can't use, isn't it? What is the reason? Power will be varying, like that we will say usually. So what is the meaning of that power? So maybe that person need to diverge the ray to this distance only, another person needs to this extent. So this distance and this distance, the focal length should vary. Okay, so for that thing, so how much degree of convergence is required or how much degree of divergence is required, that is represented by the unit power, by power. So degree of convergence or divergence is represented as power. Okay, so or we can say power is the reciprocal of, is the reciprocal of focal length, of focal length in meter. Okay, focal length in meter. If the focal length, first we should consider, convert it into meters and then find out the reciprocal, that will be the power of lens. Okay, so if suppose 20 centimeter is the focal length, Then what will be the power? How you can find out the power? First convert it into meter. That is 0.2 meter. Then take the reciprocal. Reciprocal means 1 by 0.2, that is 10 by 2, that is 5. What will be the unit of power? Power unit is diopter. Diopter is the unit of power. Representation is D. 5D. Diopter is the unit of power. Representation is D. So now you tell me, see, what is the formula for power? P equals 1 by F. Okay, unit is diopter. Now, can you say how we can define this diopter? In the last chapter in electricity, many times I defined for you that definitions of definition of units. Here now you tell me what will be the unit or how we will be defining diopter. Yes, it is the power of a lens. Power, it is the diopter is the power of a lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Yes, lens for whose focal length is equal to 1 meter. One diopter is the power of a lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Okay, so that is the representation of power. Okay, so in the case of, I told you P equals 1 by F. Convex lens, it will be, focal length will be positive in the case of convex lens. Isn't it? Convex lens is like this. So we are measuring the focal length over here. Isn't it? So concave lens, focal length will be negative. So here power also will be positive for convex lens and negative for a concave lens. So in the while we are checking, going for eye checkup and all, if the doctor is writing it as 0.02 plus 0.02 D, means what you should understand, which lens you should use? You should use a convex lens. Or if it is representing as minus 0.15 D, so what you will understand, it is a, you should use a concave lens. Okay, so which and all defects we will be using convex lens and concave lens in the next chapter in your electricity, optics, we will be studying. Okay, so understood this one? What is meant by power of a lens? Degree of convergence or divergence of a lens is called as power. Okay, power is the reciprocal of focal length. Represented unit is diopter. Focal length always should measure in meters in the case of power. Okay, so and convex lens, for a convex lens power will be positive, and for a concave lens power will be negative. Okay, so clear all of you? Okay, hope all of you understood all those things. So please don't forget to subscribe the channel, and your doubts and all, you can give it in the comment box. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.